Hello everyone, and welcome. This is the second part in making an interior car in Blender. So in the first part we have made this front shell, and in this part we are going to make the final steps and complete the modeling of this interior. So I have gone to a new layer and shift C cursor to selected, add a new cube and this cube we will scale it like this and again scale it some another time and scale on Z like this. So scale on Y and take the upper face and extrude scale shift Z, scale on X like this and push down up to G and Z like this, and the next step is to make this handle. So we can start by a plane and this plane scale another time and extrude on Z, scale shift Z and add some loop cuts, so like this. You can take this and extrude on Z. So we want it to be here in this place and scale down. The upper face will be deleted, X faces, and go to so LEDify modifier, apply the scale, and we can say that it will be 3 millimeters like this, and add subdivision surface. So we have reached to this limit for these ones, scale Z 0, and again how we can shift S cursor to selected and add an sphere. This sphere will be start with these dimensions and scale down to be like this, and we can scale it something like this and add subdivision surface like before. So I have made the geometry like this. Also we can make this smooth shading and so the final part is the glass and the roof and also the this shear. So if you see here we have two shears and some and the seat I can see. So let's As you can see, the two shares are identical, but as you can see here, there is some cubes and four. You can see that also there is a breaks. We will make them also. So let's start by making this cube. So this cube will be here and start with a cube scale 0.15, scale 0.15, and again. So this cube is very simple. So we will go to the right view, and in the right view, these ones extrude. After you go here, extrude on Y like this, and take these ones, extrude on Z. And as you can see here, there is some holes for it can be for storing bottles or something like this. So we will try to emulate this by going to make one loop cut here and another loop cut here. For this loop cut, we will be Control B, something like this. And also for this one, Control B, something like this. So we will delete these faces, but before we will take these ones and scale on Y, something like this. And the final step is to delete all these faces, and we can try to make this circle. So it's not working like as we have expected. So the next step is to make this upper part, which is a laser. So we will take these faces and shift D on Z and extrude one final time on Z. Try to subdivision surface and add a loop cuts here. And I see that this height is higher than we expect this to be, so we will push it down, and also Control Shift C to geometry and push it down. And in the blueprints, there is. So I will select all these edges and extrude Z, and finally we will fill it. And select this and join, select this and join. So we will also subdivision this one. In the render it will be 3, in the view it will be 2, and Control R. Something like this, and don't forget to make it this one it to be smooth. So we have make this inner part. Let's see if we have forget anything. Yes, it has some kind of this one. This one has this kind of pushing forward like this. So let's try to scale Shift Z exactly like this one. The next step is to try to make this bricks. It's very, very simple. How we can make it? So we will start by, let's say, start by cube and scale it. This cube, push it here and extrude on Y again, R and extrude another time, R and like this. So we will make it apply subsurface modifier and smooth shading. This one, as you can see here, is like a cylinder. If we have started with a cylinder, it might get the same result. So I will select this face and shift S cursor to selected and apply or add some cube, and scale on Y, or scale to so we have finished this part. We will start by shift D on X axis again, one time shift D on X axis, and we can push them like this. And the final step is, I will ignore this part to, if we have some time later, we can make them later. And so the next part is to make the share. I try to find some details reference of this share, and all the shares are identical. Once we have made one share, might be easier to make all the other ones. So I have found some reference for the share. So this share is which is the share which you are going to start to model. So I have started a new layer. So I will start by this part, which is the bottom part. Go to Shift C and add some plane. This plane will be, let's say, on X axis will be 4 centimeter, 0.4, and on the Y axis will be, let's say, 60 centimeter. May be, let's say, 0.5. On the y axis, let's say it will be 0.5 centimeter. And we will start by, where is this? Start to zoom in by pressing on the period key and extrude on Z like this, slightly on Z like 1 centimeter or something like that. And the next part is to control R and scale on X like this, and I'm going to take these faces and start to washing them up, extrude on Z, and you can see Control R and take these vertices, scale on X or scale on Y, so we will push them one by one like this. Anyway, we will start to making the inner part. So we will take this face and these ones and shift D on Z, extrude on Z like this, and again there is this part which is shift D on Z, severed by selection, and extrude on Z. Select all, control N, control shift C to geometry, and you can see that there is some details, and control B. So let's start to apply the subsurface modifier, and as you can see, it's now it's very horrible and nothing fancy looking to the reference. So start by pushing this to upward like this, and now the next part is and also for this one we will apply subsurface modifier, and again smooth shading, for this one we will and extrude on Y like this. For the down part, we will select and extrude on Z. So now we can select these vertices and move them down like this. So we have make one part, which is this part. As you can see, it's isn't straight like this. So what I'm going to make is to select some edge here, and this one will be scaled on X like this, and all this one will be scaled on X like this. And also this one will be scaled on X, and the final this will be scaled on X. So to be similar to the reference we are going to make, and let's try to make this one. So this one is simple. Shift C and add a plane or X 90 degrees, scale point 1, move on Z axis, and scale on x something like this, take these vertices and move them up, and control R, apply first, remove these vertices and mirror around x-axis, and we can add some loop cut here and some loop cut here, x vertices, so we are going to try to match the this blueprint, and the final thing is to extrude on Z and scale, enable clipping like this. It may be tall, so I will G on Z, something like this, and for a time select all and move them here. As you can see, it's not I mean it's not straight, so there is a lot of ways to make this effect by using lattice modifier or by controlling the vertices in this stage, but I will try to complete the model first, and let's try to extrude in Y, not as much as this, and control N. Let's first like this, and scale on scale so the remaining part is this inner part. So how we can achieve this, we can take this one and shift D on Z and R on X 90 degrees, R on Y 100 like this, and we can also simply scale this like this, and we can scale them on x axis, and they take these ones, or select all and scale on Z, scale on X like this, and the control 3 for this one, control R, Alt S, our part to be like this, and select all, scale on Y, it will be a smooth. This one will be here, and try to make it matches correctly. So if we are on Y 90 degrees, it's much better, and we will select all these and scale on X axis. We can select the vertex one by one and move to be nice and in the place. So we can select these vertices and also these ones and the scale on X. So the remaining part is to make this it at the same rotation like the seat, so it's now pretty good. So if you want to make a seam, you can easily select, I mean selecting this part and control B, slightly seam like this and extrude Alt S down like this, so we have make a seam to this seat. If you want to happy with the position, so you can apply the mirror modifier and Control Shift C to geometry. So we have make one share. There is some, you can see there is some plastics here, you can make them also. So select this one vertices, cursor selected, add some plane, and this plane will be here. Extrude in Z, extrude on Z, and also select these faces and extrude on X, select all and we can select this one and name it to or and now control N, try to smooth it, in the right view select all these as you can see. So this one will be a plastic and we will now mirror them, mirror them around object which will be 21 and apply the mirror modifier. Subdivision surface will be in the viewer 2 and in the render will be 3. So we can see that now we can make a circle, try to make this one like a handle or a screw. So this one, try to select this vertices, cursor selected, and add a circle. This circle will have 6 vertices and R on Y 90 degrees, scale them down and select all, extrude on X axis like this and fill faces and join these ones. Extrude scale shift X 0.4 and extrude in X like this. Select all and move them here and select all faces and control N to apply the normalize, control 2 so it's much better to select all these edges and shift E, but no matter. So we'll select all these edges, select these edges and shift G the same length and shift E like this and apply the smooth shading in the view. It will be 2 and in the and also mirror again mirror for the shear it has no mirror. Yes, so now we let's save this up to this moment. So now we have one shear and this shear will be RZ90. So let's apply the mirrors. This one will be mirror and try to control J RZ. So there is some so because it's not one object, let's try there is something. Select all RZ, so it's not working correctly. So I will join them and RZ90 and in this third layer I will move the shear to this place, shift D on X axis like this, select all, shift D on Y like this and select this, shift D on Y as you can see the shears is in the bottom, so we'll move them here. And as you can see the next step is to make the doors and finalize this design. So we will start where is this is the cube and in the this part is the door. So I will move to layer 3 and here in layer 2 we have this. We will move to this layer and start to organize things. So this start to move in layer 1 and what in layer 3 we will move in layer 2 and in this layer we have the shears move to layer 2 and so to the DS to the door we will select the door like this and it's yet small. So because we have selected origin individual origin, so we will scale this not too much like this and so let's start by making the outer rim. So we have now this shell and let's start by making a plane and this plane will be here and scale on Z So we start to making the roof first. The roof is something like this, and here something like this, and for this part we have this will be down like this, and scale on x axis we will move to layer 5 to the doors. Shift D on Y, and we will mirror them, mirror around the glass at center, and also it will be this one will be mirrored around the glass of at center. All this one control L modifiers. Control L modifiers and Control L modifiers. Now all the doors is also these doors Control L modifiers. So I think that the doors must be here. And we have now make this interior part. So the next step, as you can see, the handles isn't correctly. So select this hand and Control N. Select this hand and Control N. So we will select these bricks and move them here, and here in this place we will add a plane, or this plane will be like this, and it will be in this place, scale X. So we are going to make some sheet of glass. So we will select this face and insert something like this, and delete this face, select all and extrude on Y something slightly, and select all this, shift D on Y severed by selection, and this one will fill, and remove back, and it will be the glass. So let's see, we can recalculate normals over flip direction, and so we will select some parts from this face and this face, and select E and Y, scale on Y 0 and E on Y like this, and move this one to be here, move this one to be here. So we will start to make some tests to this. Control Alt 0 and look camera to view, push back the camera and change it to cycles. Dimensions will be like this. Up to this moment we haven't made any changes to the materials. We will start to make some default materials by selecting this sheet of glass, and the color will be pure white. Also so all these sheets will be glass, and also this one will be a glass. We can make the floor, this floor will be here. And shift D on Z, scale on Y. Let's see in the top view. So we will scale on X axis like this. And we select all these and extrude in y axis and extrude on y. So move them like this and move them like this. Let's isolate, and this one we will subdivide a few times like this and subdivide again a few times. Final time, select all faces and extrude on Z. And select individual origins and scale shift Z. So we must select one by one. So remove doubles, and what I'm going to make is to make a nice effect like you will see now. So we'll select some faces like here, especially it can be some array modifier may be useful in this method. So we will selecting these faces one by one, and once we have selected this, extrude in Z axis and scale in the individual origin, scale shift Z like this. Let's say it will be 0.10. And also if you have the time, you can select all the remaining ones by this, and all these will be extruded on Z and scale shift Z 0.8. So in the side view we'll add a plane here, and this plane will be the main light. And it will be an emission shader of 9 pure white. And this will be here. And we can also make an fill light here. This will be fill light and emission. One, the light will be slightly blue. Shift D on Y R, and it will be the rim light. The color will be slightly yellow, and it will be not seen in the camera. Let's try to see how it looks. As you can see, this one is seen in the camera, so how we can not this one but this one. So let's try. As you can see, we can add the an HDR. So as you can see, I have added some HDR, and we have forget to smoothing the main part, and it can be apply some subdivision surface. And as you can see, without applying any materials, it's very very beautiful, and the shares also its size and its dimensions is correctly right. As you can see, in the next step we are going to make a wireframe render of this model and fix these things in the front. But at total, it's a good start to make materials and rendering this interior. So see you in the third section.